Hello students, today I am teaching to you the subject of science, class 8, chapter 4, materials, metals and non-metals. Metals and non-metals. In this chapter, in last class, I taught you the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. What occurs if a metal is react with oxygen or a non-metal is reacts with oxygen. Today in this sequence of chemical properties of metals and non-metals, I will study a new topic, what happens when a metal or non-metal is react with water. Water means here the chemical formula of water is H2O. The main point is, When a metal reacts with water, then what is the product formed? Reacts with water. For example, we take a metal plus water in a general way, what it is formed? Water breaks into water molecules. Suppose that this is a water molecule, and when it undergoes in reaction, it breaks into H plus and OH negative ions. How reaction performed, it depends upon the dissociation of the compound. Water dissociate in the form of H plus ions and OH negative ions, and metals, we know that they dissociate and forms a positive ion. That's why the metals are called, they are electropositive in nature. Due to formation of these positive ions of metals, metals are called electro positive in nature, and due to this electropositive nature property, they are basic nature compounds or element. So in undergoing a chemical reaction, always positive ion combines with the negative ion, and it forms MOH, and this ion is called hydroxide ion, and this is a metal. So this form a metal हाइड्रो ऑक्साइड कंपाउंड एंड व्हाट दिस हाइड्रोजन आयन इज लेफ्ट इनसाइड दिस सॉल्यूशन इट कंबाइंस विद अ हाइड्रोजन मॉलिक्यूल हाइड्रोजन एटम एंड फॉर्म्स हाइड्रोजन गैस लाइक H2. सो इफ वी रिप्रेजेंट दिस केमिकल रिएक्शन दिस पैटर्न इज कॉल्ड रिएक्शन इज रिटर्न इन वर्ड फॉर्म वर्ड इक्वेशन chemical equation written in words, we can say that. But it is more tedious way to represent a chemical equation by naming each and every compound. To overcome this problem, we use while writing the chemical equation with its symbolic form, like metal is react with water, it forms metal hydroxide, hydroxide, balancing of equation. It is the another point. Here we only try to write what product is formed. It forms a metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas is formed along with the compound. So we can write that when a metal reacts with water, then a metal hydroxide, metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas are formed. Clear? When a metal react with water, it forms a metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. And the intensity of reaction means speed of reaction of a metal with water, it depends on the chemical reactivity of the metal. Some metals react fastly, which is called vigorously, even with the cold water. Some metals react with vigorously or fastly even with the cold water. Some metals react with the hot water Some metals react with steam, means some metals react with steam. Steam contains higher temperature as compared to the hot water. So here I tried to develop an idea about the chemical reaction of metals with water. Some metals simply, if you want to react with water, reaction is performed vigorously. Very fast reaction is performed, and some metal react with hot water, they cannot perform reaction with this cold water, and some metals are react with very high temperature water, means the water present in steam form, then the reaction of this metal is considerable, otherwise reaction is not performed, means no product is formed. And some of the metals, whether the cold water, hot water or steam water is present, they do not react any how temperature of water is available for the reaction. So water is same, but their temperature performs an important or vital role in undergoing a reaction, and it depends upon the chemical reactivity of the metal. If a metal is very reactive in nature, then it easily react with cold water and the product is formed, like metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas is formed. So which type of water is required for undergoing the reaction, it totally depend upon the chemical reactivity of the metal. Suppose that sodium is a very reactive metal. So sodium easily combined with the water, cold water, it form a sodium hydroxide easily, and hydrogen gas is formed. But if we take a less reactive metal and combined with the cold water, react with the cold water, there is no product is formed, means reaction is not performed. So the reaction of the water with the metal is depends upon the chemical reactivity of the metal. Chemical reactivity of the metal. So sodium is a very reactive metal, that's why it easily, or we can say the violently react with even with the cold water, and it forms the required product. But magnesium, capital M, small g, magnesium is less reactive as compared to the sodium metal. So magnesium does not perform a very good reaction with the cold water. It requires hot water or boiling water or steam water to perform the reaction. So magnesium react with hot water, it forms a magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. The metals zinc and iron. Zinc एंड आयरन, आयरन सिंबल इज कैपिटल एफ स्मॉल ई, आर लेस रिएक्टिव इन नेचर, मीन्स देयर केमिकल रिएक्टिविटी आर वेरी लेसर एज कंपेयर टू द सोडियम एंड मैग्नीशियम. सो द जिंक एंड आयरन दे डू नॉट रिएक्ट विद वाटर, इवन द वाटर इज हॉट और इन स्टीम फॉर्म. Whether the water is present in steam and hot form, they cannot react with the water because the chemical reactivity of the zinc and iron metal is very less as compared to the sodium and magnesium. So, write again, sodium react with water, it forms sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. How can you detect this gas is an hydrogen gas? To determine or to detect the whether the gas formed is hydrogen or not, we perform an experiment. Suppose that we take a test tube which is filled with water and a small amount of sodium is dropped, sodium is dropped inside the water, it goes under the product formation, and according to our theoretical knowledge, it forms a sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Hydrogen is a gas, so all of you know that gas is try to escape from this test tube. So gas is present upper side of the compound. And if we bring a burning matchstick to the matchstick near to the test tube, this is a test tube, it explosively burned with a pop sound, explosively burnt sound is produced. And this pop sound signifies that the gas formed inside the test tube during the reaction is a hydrogen gas. The pop sound, if we bring a burning matchstick near to the test tube, it explosively burned and produced a pop sound. This pop sound signifies that the reaction present inside the test tube is a hydrogen gas. So we easily detect the presence of hydrogen gas or the formation of hydrogen gas by doing or by performing this experiment. Second thing is that मैग्नीशियम इज ऑल्सो रिएक्ट विद वाटर, इट फॉर्म मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड बैलेंसिंग, आफ्टर बैलेंसिंग द एक्शन दिस इज कॉल्ड ओ एच होल स्क्वायर एंड हाइड्रोजन गैस इज फॉर्म बस हेयर बट हेयर हाइड्रो वाटर इज इट इज इन हॉट फॉर्म और आइदर इन स्टीम फॉर्म देन दिस रिएक्शन विल बी परफॉर्म्ड विगोरसली अदरवाइज इन कोल्ड वाटर द रिएक्शन फॉर्मेशन द स्पीड ऑफ द रिएक्शन इज स्लो एज कंपेयर टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ हॉट और स्टीम वाटर. सोडियम इज वेरी रिएक्टिव मेटल. सोडियम इज अ वेरी रिएक्टिव मेटल एंड इट इजिली कैचेज फायर even it is left open or it is kept exposed to air so to prevent its reaction with the moisture or the other gases like air it is sodium is kept in kerosene to prevent the reaction of this sodium with the moisture and the other surrounding gases it is kept in the kerosene and potassium is also a very reactive metal it is represented by the capital symbol K in chemistry so potassium and sodium, this is sodium and this is potassium, both are kept in kerosene to prevent the reaction from the surrounding. Now next is the what happens if a non-metal is react with water. Non-metal, remember this, non-metals do not react with water. Non-metals do not react with water. Non-metals do not react with water. Some of the reactive non-metals for example if you talk about the sulfur, this is a non-metal and this is not undergo a reaction with water. So we leads to a conclusion that non-metals do not react with water. But in fact, some of the reactive non-metals are kept under water to protect them from the action of air, or we can say there from the oxidation of the non-metal, for example phosphorus is a non-metal, it is a non-metal, but it is easily, phosphorus is represented by the capital letter P, it is easily react with the oxygen because it is a very reactive non-metal. Phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal, so it easily oxidizes with the oxygen and form oxide of phosphorus. To prevent the oxidation of this phosphorus with the oxygen, we kept the phosphorus in water bottle. So the phosphorus cannot perform reaction with the atmospheric air. Okay, thank you.